future. We want to welcome our viewers in the United States and around the world. This is New Day. It is Monday, April 23rd, 6 o'clock here in New York. Here's our starting line. Pretty much on a much brighter note, we have some breaking royal baby news. Kate Middleton, the Duchess of Cambridge, is in a London hospital in the early stages of labor with her third child, CNN's Max. Okay, LeBron James refusing to lose. Nuclear weapons is now complete. They vow that they will halt nuclear and missile tests and shut down a nuclear facility. This announcement comes just days before North Korean. So there was this fiery exchange between CNN's Dana Bash and White House counselor Kellyanne Conway on CNN's State of the Union. Dana asked Conway about her husband, a well-known attorney named George Conway, posting or retweeting messages that are critical of President Trump. Here's part of this interview. Okay, what was that? Let's discuss with CNN political. Margaret, I don't know. I'm feeling like the question about Kellyanne's husband struck a nerve with her. What happened there?
Well, why should I have to? I truly don't think any person who is
there, right there, because she was saying this only happens to me. Kellyanne was acting as though we would never have asked anybody else. If I like to play the game, if this were President Obama, okay? If David Axelrod's wife, when President Obama was in the White House, was tweeting, asking, wouldn't we have asked David Axelrod about that?
Because then Kellyanne's asking a question about what her husband's doing. And I think the question was, what's up with your husband's tweets?
I think fair question to ask, is this, what's going on where your husband seems to be undermining the policies that you're fighting?
Political point of view.
Kirsten, what do you think? I hear you, but I don't want to cater to a valid question.
They have different political perspectives. We know he doesn't like the president. I mean, he also demonstrated and really illustrated how uncomfortable it made her feel. But I identify with that comment.
I understand, and I appreciate that you're pointing out this perspective from your own personal perspective. I think that's really helpful. But let's just remember for one second that it is also President Trump who has gone after Ted Cruz's wife.
Exactly.
Andrew McCabe's wife.
Yeah.
So Kellyanne Conway saying you never go after the spouse. Tell your boss.
No, Kelly. I mean, Kelly.
What do you think, Margaret? Amy Chosek covered Hillary Clinton's presidential ambitions. Now, Chosek has a new memoir out this week. Are you here?
Thanks for having me.
Wow, what a read.
Thank you.
There's a lot of juicy tidbits in here. And it is interesting to see how your life, as all of our lives as reporters, and particularly in the field, are affected by the subjects that we cover. You write in the book, why was it so all-consuming?
Wow. That was my life.
And so then,
too much information, sorry.
No, hey, man, all women can relate to this. And so then you get the plum assignment, and you get to cover Hillary Clinton, and everything was wine and roses after that. Actually, what you write is that, you know, that came with its own set of challenges, and that was at times, I guess, disconcerting, because here was this campaign that was all about breaking the glass ceiling.
Right. I mean, I want to...
campaign did say sexist things to you and treat you in a sexist way. Not all, but some.
Right, some. And that was...
For sure. you write, I think, pretty candidly about the regrets that you have about some of your coverage. You write this. The Bernie... Do you regret now reporting on the hacked John Podesta DNC? You had become a pawn, I mean, basically, in the Russian intelligence effort to disseminate these.
Absolutely, we all did. I mean, every member of the media.
Site, do you think that, why do you think Hillary Clinton lost the election? As you do, covering her for as long as you have. Do you think that there's another chapter for Hillary Clinton? No pun intended.
I mean,
she went to Barbara Bush's funeral this weekend.
Liked her. They liked working with her when she was Secretary of State. She reached across the aisle when she was Senator. John McCain really liked her. That's surprising.
Wow.
Shocking.
You're right. That is breaking news. Amy Chosek, the book is great. It's Chasing Hillary. It comes out tomorrow. Has all sorts of really great insights and juicy tidbits. Thanks.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thanks so much for being here.